a song that can make me wanna roll my windows down and cruise.
What up, Nelly?
Yeah, when I first saw that bikini top on her, she's popping right out of the South Georgia water. Thought, oh good lord, she had them long tan legs. Couldn't help myself, so I walked up and said, well, baby, you a song.
Que dijo que no iba a comer healthy.
Con más nada que comer.
Son muchos años que pasaron sin decirte quiero. Y en verdad te quiero. Pero encuentro formas de engañar mi corazón.
Son muchos años que pasaron sin robarte un beso. Solo quiero un beso. Y por esa boca no me importa ser ladrón.
No puede ser que no he encontrado todavía las palabras. Y en esa noche no dije nada.
No puede ser que en un segundo me perdí en tu mirada. Cuando por dentro yo te gritaba.
Baby, so tell me what's flexible dieting. And how can you eat all that and still like get to your fitness goals?
Cheating, not counting it.
No, but you know how. How are you gonna balance it out?
By eating less.
Because? Why are you gonna eat less?
Because I'm overeating calories.
So if you eat less tomorrow, it balances out?
But you still don't know how many you ate, so you don't really know.
So it's an estimate. But essentially, calories in? Yes.
So, thank you to my boyfriend for trying to explain to you what flexible dieting is and kind of how it works and how we use it to be able to enjoy food a little bit more. But he got a little camera shy, so I'm gonna expand on what he was trying to say. So first of all, it all comes down to our calorie need, and this is gonna be different for every person. That's why on my last video I didn't want to show you like how many calories I was eating or like the portions that I was eating, because I don't want you to copy like my current intake, because I'm actually on a cut, so my calories are very low. So I don't want anyone to be thinking that like, oh my god, I should eat these many calories to like get to this goal, because every person is gonna be different. And yes, there is averages for like your gender, age and height, but it all comes down to like how fast your metabolism is, like how active you are, like how many calories you're burning per day. So depending on that, like, depending on the amount of calories that you burn every day, you're gonna that's gonna be like your maintenance level. So if you just want to maintain your current weight, you're gonna eat the exact same calories that you burn every day, and you just like stay there. That's the magic of it, because it's just math. It's like, so I don't want to lose weight, I don't want to gain weight, I just stay at the same level as the calories I'm burning. If I want to gain weight, because I want to gain muscle and I want to, you know, look bigger, look like stronger or whatever, I need to eat more, because you're not gonna like create any muscle mass if you don't have extra calories. And yes, it's gonna come with like fat gain as well, but you need that extra energy, extra fuel to create muscle mass. And then what most people want in this life is to lose weight. So if you want to lose weight or lose fat, you're gonna have to eat less than your maintenance level. So a good way to find out, I mean, you can always like go to a nutritionist, go to the doctor, and they can kind of tell you how much they think you burn. But then my recommendation is track your food for a few days and figure out if you're like gaining, losing, or maintaining. And then after like a few days, a few weeks, you can kind of tell like what's that level for you. So then when you discover that, when you figure that out, there comes the concept of like flexible dieting. And to explain that, I guess I need to explain also like macros, which are protein, carbs, and fats. And these are the macronutrients that are gonna give you calories. So for every gram of protein and carbs, you have 4 calories. And for every gram of fat, you have 9 calories. This is why you usually need less grams of fat than carbs and proteins, because they give you a lot more calorie, a lot more energy. So you need less of it. So I guess for beginners, I would just recommend to track calories. But if you want to go one step above that, there is good ratios that you could follow for all these macros to make sure that you have the right amount of protein to build muscle, right amount of carbs to have energy for your workouts and your day-to-day life, and right amount of fats for like basic body functions. So when you like convert that into flexible dieting, you are just gonna notice that every food has their macros. So like chicken is mostly protein, rice is mostly carbs, and like almond butter is mostly fats. So every food has its macros, and at the end of the day, it's all gonna come down to if you ate more or less than your calorie needs, right? So and that can be in one day, or that can be in like 1 week, 1 month, whatever. So the way we use this concept of like macros and flexible dieting to be able to like enjoy food sometimes is, if one day I went above my calorie needs, then the next day I'm just gonna go below, and it's gonna like balance it out. For me, for example, that I'm trying to like lose weight long term, like lose at least like a few grams or a pound per week, I need to, if I'm gonna eat a lot in one day, I need to balance it out with like 2 or 3 days of like being like consistently low. So that's kind of like, so at the end of like those like, let's say 4 days, my levels are like, my intake is gonna be lower, even though I had one day where I went up. So that's kind of how it works. It's like a balance. And then at the end of the day, my check-ins are like on Thursdays or Fridays. So if I have my cheat meal on Sunday and I give myself those 4 days to like go back to normal and like let my body, you know, digest all the food and like get rid of all the extra water from the cheat meal and all that, by Thursday or Friday, I'm back to my normal weight or less, because
like the total amount of calories was, it's less than what I needed to like maintain, so I'm losing weight. So I hope that makes sense. Hopefully, if like I'm trying to put it as simple as possible, because it's really a simple, like a simple concept. You just need to like be mentally strong and understand food and understand how your body works. It's a simple math equation. It's like I eat more, I gain weight, I eat less, I lose weight. And like I said, this can be in one day or it can be in a period of like a week. So I use a week as my time period to be on a deficit. I don't do it by day, I do it as a week, as a whole week. So I know that if I have one day that I went over, I have all other 6 days to take it back down. So I don't really know what else to say, but as always, if you have any questions, comment below, because I do want to help you guys. And I want to make these videos a little more helpful for you, rather than just like watching me eat and not knowing how, why I eat it, or like how. I'm gonna start doing like more specific questions. I know I put a post about like, why did I eat egg whites instead of eggs and things like that. It all comes down to what I explained today, but I don't wanna take any more time. So we're just gonna keep it to this for now. And next videos are gonna have more like details about my diet. So, and things that might help your diet and your training programs. So I hope you liked it. Give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel, because I need your help for that. And yeah, I hope to see you guys in the next video. Thank you so much. Bye.
Yo también sentí su jala.
Déjame robarte un beso que te enamore.
Y tú no te vayas.